Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at how we can set up and use photo tags inside of Dashpivot. And the tags are really important when you've got thousands, if not tens of thousands of photos uploaded into Dashpivot in the photo section. The tags really help to organize all of these photos. So it helps you to find certain photos later on. On the left-hand side, you can see that we have a list of tags already set up. I'm going to show you how we can set these up in just a moment and how we can apply them when we take photos using the Dashpivot app. But I just want to show you first that what the value is of setting up these tags. So here we have a couple hundred photos. And if we click on any one of these tags that we have set up, for example, delay, immediately it's going to refine what we see down to only the photos that have the delay tag applied to them. And we can actually use multiple tags in combination with each other because each photo can have multiple tags applied to it. We can narrow our search even further. So maybe we click on Northern Compound as the zone that we're in. And now we can see only the delays in the Northern Compound. And so it refines to just this photo here. And if we open that up, we can see the picture of the piece of plant. And we can see that it was a plant breakdown. So it really helps us to find information really quickly inside of Dashpivot. And the tagging works in conjunction with any of the other filters. So we can search by text, we can filter by the person who uploaded the photo, we can filter by date range and all of those things as well, in combination with filtering by these tags. So if it's your first time setting up photo tags, you won't see anything like this on the left straight away. You'll see something called project photo tags and you'll see something called team photo tags. And each of them has an edit button next to them. The difference here is that project photo tags will appear in all of the team folders within that project. So if we set up some project photo tags, then all of these team folders are going to be able to use all of those tags that we set up. Whereas if we set up what we call team photo tags, those are only going to appear and be available for each specific team folder. So in this case, we've actually set up all of our tags as project photo tags, and you can see that they've actually been set up in groups. So we have a group of general photo tags, and then we have a group of tags for different work activities. In your case, it could be work activities, it could be assets, it could be different parties or subcontractors. And then we have a group of tags for different areas or zones or locations. So this is pretty typical, but you can see that we haven't set up any team photo tags just yet. So we're going to go ahead and do that in this case. So we're going to click on the edit button. And it's actually just a shortcut. So it's taken us to the settings section, to the team photo tag section. And you can see here, it actually displays all of the project photo tags, but we can't edit those here because we're still inside the team folder. If we wanted to edit the project photo tags, we'd have to go to the project folder. But if we scroll down, or I'll just minimize this, we can see that we have our team photo tag section down here. And we can see there's a button to add a new tag group. And we're going to click on that. So we're going to create a group of photo tags for different areas. So we're going to call the group name areas, and then the tags that we're going to enter are going to be area 1, area 2, area 3, and area 4. And once we've done that, we're just going to click the save button. Now, once we've done that, we can see that there's the list here. We can edit the tags that appear within this group. So we can just click the actions and click on edit. We can also delete later on if need be. And if we head back to the photo section, you can actually see if we scroll down, you can see that we now have those team photo tags for these different areas. So let's try this out in the app. So here we are in the Dashpivot app. I've got my tablet open here and we're in the same team folder and we're in the photo section. All I'm going to do is click on the camera icon to take a new photo. And I'm just going to take a photo of my boot. And we can mark that up. So we can draw on it, add some arrows, add some text. I'm happy with that, so I'm just going to click done. And then instead of taking another photo, I'm just going to click next. And this is where we can add a description for our photo. So maybe we type in boot. And then you can see all of our photo tags listed below that. So let me just move that out of the way. And you can see that our new photo tags that we set up for the different areas are displayed here. So maybe we are in area one and the work activity is related to demolition. And maybe the reason that we took this photo was for safety. And once we've done that, we can just click save. And that photo will start to upload into Dashpivot. Once that upload is complete, we can come back to the website. And so we can see that our new photo has now uploaded into Dashpivot. Now, if we scroll down and find our team photo tags that we've just created and click on area one, you can see that it now refines the results to only show us the photo that has the area one tag applied to it. And of course, this is only the one photo that has had that applied. So that helps us find those images really quickly. If we set up tags later and we want to apply those to some photos that have already been uploaded, that's fine as well. We can just open up the photo, click the Add Tag button, and we can select what tags we want to apply to that photo. So now we've selected area one on this photo. We can go to the next one and apply another tag. Maybe this is area four, and so on and so forth. So it's very easy to see not only what photo tags have been applied to a photo, but we can add additional ones if need be. If we need to remove a photo tag from a photo, we just hover on it and just click the little X button. Confirm. And that's it. That's how we can use photo tags inside of Dashpivot. If you'd like to check out our other videos covering different use cases and other functionality, feel free to head to the tutorials section on the Dashpivot website. But if you get stuck or have a question, you can always reach us via the live chat, which is this button down here on the Dashpivot website. The live chat is also available in the Dashpivot app. So I hope that this video has been useful, and thanks for watching.